Hey there, this is Sira and you're watching Tech for Luddites. The most frequent buzzword you're going to hear in 2019 is 5G. Does it warrant all the hype? Or is it just the latest scheme by smartphone manufacturers to re-energize the industry and shake you down for more money? Let's find out. Every decade or so, we move on from one generation of mobile networks to the next. With the analog 1G, we had only voice. With 2G, we switched to digital, which enabled voice, messages, and with the introduction of GPRS in 1997, some kind of access to the internet. 3G made the proliferation of social media apps and video calls possible. And 4G finally allowed us to stream Netflix on the go. It also, unfortunately, led to the rise of the scourge of the internet, Snapchat. So what is 5G exactly? The Next Generation Mobile Networks Alliance states that for something to be considered 5G, it must offer data rates of several tens of megabits per second to tens of thousands of users simultaneously, while a minimum of 1 gigabit per second should be offered to tens of workers on the same office floor. But 4G coverage remains spotty and we still have data caps. Why don't we focus on those instead of trying to get faster internet? The CEO of Three, a UK-based network operator, says, "The capacity part of 5G is the true revolution." Three commissioned a study from Ovum, which found that 5G FWA would be capable of delivering speeds of up to 100 Mbps, more than double the average UK fixed line speed of 46 Mbps. The exponential increase in network capacity may mean that providers start offering true unlimited data, or at least high enough to compete with fiber. Knowing them, they probably won't though. 5G will use two spectra, sub-6 and millimeter wave. Sub-6 will use frequencies below 6 GHz, cannibalize some of the 4G spectrum, and provide speeds of up to 100 Mbps. You might be thinking that that's not much faster than 4G, and you'd be right. The real breakthrough in 5G is millimeter wave. It will utilize hitherto unused frequencies in the 30 to 300 GHz range and provide data rates up to 10 Gbps. Eventually, for now, it'll probably be closer to 1 Gbps. The problem with these higher frequencies is that they can be blocked by walls, foliage, rain, and even your hand. That's why mobile phones with 5G will have redundancy built in, so you don't accidentally block your signal. It also means that we have to have small cells every few hundred meters in order to have proper coverage. In fact, there are many breakthrough technologies that will come together to ensure that these powerful but ephemeral waves can make their way to you. You'll probably need mini cell towers on every other street lamp. That is, however, a small price to pay for a much faster, low latency and higher capacity internet that will power the next generation of apps and technologies for years to come. Who the hell are you?
I'm a smarter and better looking version of you from another dimension. I'm here to dispel some of the disinformation that you've been spreading and give your audience truth.
Oh no, you don't. If you cross this line, you will initiate a vacuum decay and annihilate the multiverse. Excuse me, but this is my channel. I don't jump between dimensions and interfere with your videos, do I?
Now that she's been dealt with, let me tell you the truth about 5G. These millimeter waves are not what they seem. They're high energy waves that can be condensed into narrow beams using phased array antennas. That, coupled with the fact that these small cells are going to be ubiquitous and everywhere around us, made me suspicious. I dug the depths of the internet and found a resistance movement forming in the comment section of popular tech channels. I finally came across an expert who could break it down for us.
They have carrier waves over the millimeter wave. They can make you sexually aroused, nauseous, stressed. It burns the atmosphere. It's a depopulation plan.
The government is going to saturate the air with these dangerous high-frequency waves and use them to control our minds. They'll sterilize us, eugenicize us, and make us pay for it with their irresistible, unlimited plans. We must fight back. If you see any 5G towers being set up near your home, you must procure a blunt weapon and smash it to pieces. Oh no, they've discovered me. I must go, but remember what I told you.
No!
Interdimensional clones are a pain in the butt, man.
But Sira, what she said was the truth. 5G is using higher frequencies, higher than even microwaves. They're going to cook us alive with our own premium flagships.
Yes, 5G might be using higher frequencies, but they still fall under the realm of non-ionizing radiation, which means that it can't knock electrons off your molecules and it isn't going to cause mutations in your DNA or brain cancer. Just for reference, the frequency of visible light is 400 to 800 terahertz. That's three orders of magnitude higher than millimeter wave. And unless you live under a rock, you are inundated by visible light all day. Like,
I'm bathing in it right now. But seriously, the greatest danger posed to your brain and well-being will probably be from the 8K photorealistic virtual reality goodness that you're going to stream on your 5G headset. And that is just one of the many applications that 5G will be used for. Industrial uses include remote control of equipment and thousands of tiny sensors that will let you know tons of information about different processes. The 1 millisecond latency enabled by 5G will allow self-driving cars to talk to each other and thus be more responsive to their surroundings. You may no longer require expensive rigs for gaming. The graphics can be rendered at a remote server and streamed straight to your computer. Nvidia is already doing this with GeForce Now, but the 1 millisecond latency of 5G will finally make this a complete experience. Okay, so that wraps up everything about 5G and the changes it's going to bring. Only one question remains. When is it coming to India? According to my sources, 5G will be coming to India sometime between the completion of Bangalore Metro Phase 2 and this channel releasing weekly videos. Other sources say that Jio will bring 5G to India by the end of 2019. It's already being tested on a small scale in the United States in the form of 5G-based wireless home internet service and coming to many countries by early 2019. So let's keep our fingers crossed and hope for the best. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you absolutely loved it, then hit the subscribe button. And if you don't want to miss any of my upcoming videos, make sure to hit the bell icon. I'll see you guys really soon. Bye!